Surah Nisa 4 and Ayah 3. وَإِنْ خِفْتُمْ أَلَّا تُفْسِدُوا فِي الْيَتَامَى فَانْكِحُوا مَا طَوَبَ لَكُمْ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ مَثْنَى وَثُلَاثَ وَرُبَاعَ فَإِنْ خِفْتُمْ أَلَّا تَعْدِلُوا فَوَاحِدَةً أَوْ مَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُكُمْ ذَلِكَ أَدْنَى أَلَّا تَعُولُوا. And if you are fearful that you cannot do justice in the orphans, so marry from your woman, from the woman orphans who seem good to you, twos and threes and fours. Then if you are fearful that you cannot be equitable or equalized, then marry one, or marry what your right hand possesses. That would be lowlier if you do not support. The previous ayat and this ayah, how they are interlinked. In that ayah, Allah is saying that they are asking a legal advice from you, the messenger, and Allah gives an advice that you do not give what the, for the orphan women. And the ayah says, whatever is decided over you in the book concerning the orphan woman, you do not give them, and you desire to marry them. You desire to marry them, but you are not giving them you do not give, and you do not marry them. In this ayah, Allah says, what for the orphan woman, what it says, and what is written in the book, that if you fear, now this is the fear of the man. That fear was a woman, fear of woman. In this ayah, if you are fearful, the man is fearing that you cannot do justice in the orphans. So marry from women who seem good to you, twos and threes and fours. What this ayah says, if you see in the orphan woman that men, believing women, cannot do justice among the women, believing women, the orphan women, you marry them, two and three and four. The question is, previous ayah says you desire to marry, you don't marry. This ayah says you marry them. Order says you marry two. This ayah starts with two women to marry, and three women to marry, and four women to marry. It starts from two. We all are marrying one. So the problem is, now you have to understand this ayah. Allah says if men, believing men, fear that they cannot do justice among the orphaned women, so you marry them two, and three and four. This is a solution for the woman. But again, further he says, I will not read further. And if you fear, فَإِنْ خِفْتُمْ أَلَّا تَعْدِلُوا فَوَاحِدًا. And if you fear that you cannot be equitable, or you cannot be equitable, then marry one. So now in the Arabic, the order is order. You understand order? It is not a permission to you. It is an order to all men of all times, that if you fear that you cannot do justice among the women, then you marry two and three and four. And if you fear that you cannot be equitable among men, among women, then you marry one. So the choice is put on the man. If he fears that injustice is being done in the woman, among the woman class in the whole world, then you marry two and three and four. And if you fear that I cannot be equitable among them, then I marry one. So the choice is on me, but the order is both. You have to take up the choice. Now, we come to this ayat, that the ayat which says that if you cannot be equitable between women, then marry one. Now, this is a fear, two fears of men. Before the woman was fearing, now the man is fearing. If the man is fearing that he cannot do justice between the woman, then he must marry two and three and four, plural marriage. But if he is fearing that he cannot be equitable, then he marries one. So the next rule we have applied on us, and we are marrying one. We cannot be equitable, so we marry one. But Allah says in further ayat, Surah 4 and 129 ayat, وَلَن تَسْتَطِيعُوا أَلَّا أَن تَعْدِلُوا بَيْنَ النِّسَاءِ وَلَوْ حَرَصْتُمْ فَلَا تَمِيلُوا كُلَّ الْمَيْلِ فَتَذَرُوهَا كَالْمُعَلَّقَةِ وَإِن تُصْلِحُوا وَتَتَّقُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمًا. And you do not have the capability to be equitable between women. Even if you are eager, so do not inclining totally to any one of them, then you leave her as suspended. And if you amend, correct, and take guard, then surely Allah is forgiving, merciful. Now Allah is explaining that I said I am fearful. I am fearful that I cannot be equitable between women. So I marry. How many women I marry? One. I cannot be equitable. Now Allah says in the further ayat that you men, believing men, do not have the capability to be equitable among between women. You don't have the capability to be equal between two women. You don't have the capability. So I marry? How many? How many? Huh? No. Listen to me very carefully. Allah said, if you men fear that you have to be equitable between women, then you marry one. If you men fear that you cannot be equitable between women, then marry one. But Allah says you don't have the capability of being equitable. So I should remove fear. Very good. Remove the fear and marry. Yes. Look, women understand better. So now what happens? وَلَن تَسْتَسْتَعْدِلُ أَنْ تَعْدِلُ بَيْنَ النِّسَاءِ وَلَوْ حَرَسْتُمْ فَلَا تَمِيلُ كُلَّ الْمَيْلِ فَتَذَرُوهَا كَالْمُعَلَّقَةِ وَإِنْ تُصْلِحُوا وَتَتَّقُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. And you do not have the capability to be equitable between women. Then if you, even if you are eager, so you do not inclining totally to any one of them, then you leave her suspended by marrying more than one. If you amend and correct and take guard, then surely Allah is forgiving and most merciful. Now what happened? Allah is telling us, the man, look, this is the balance. If Allah says you cannot keep a balance between two women or three women or four women, you can never be able to do this. So Allah says you do not incline to any one of them. Incline means bending. Do not incline. Leave her suspended. Until you leave her so as to leave any woman suspended, then only you can marry another woman. If you will be inclined, you cannot marry. Very simple. فَلَا تَمِيلُوا كُلَّ الْمَيْلِ. Do not incline, totally do not be inclined. Leave, so leave, then what I do? Then leave her suspended. Give her time to rest with the children, live her life, get married. The question is, the problem is, what Allah is saying very clearly. فَلَا تَمِيلُوا. Do not incline. كُلَّ الْمَيْلِ. كُلَّ الْمَيْلِ, totally you are inclined. If you are in that state, you can never marry because you are inclined, totally inclined. So Allah says, فَتَذَرُوهَا كَالْمُعَلَّقَةِ. Then what if I do not incline, and I do not incline totally, what I do? I leave her suspended. I leave her suspended. فَتَذَرُوهَا. So then leave her, then leave her as suspended. As suspended. So when she's suspended, then only you can marry.
Is the second marriage ayat? Is it ayat-e-mahkumat?
Okay. Now, the Quran, the question is that it is a mahkum means a order from Allah. It is a conditional order that if you fear that you cannot do justice among the women, then you can marry two and three and four. It is a conditional. But if you fear that you cannot be equitable, and Allah says that you can never be equitable, you remove the fear and you can marry more than one. So it depends upon the man. There are men who are really fearful and they cannot remove the fear. They cannot remove the fear, equitable fear, so they will remain and have one wife. So order, it is an order, but it is a conditional order depending upon the men. If the man is not able to remove the fear from his life, he can have one wife. And if the man can remove the fear, he can have more than one wife. So it is a conditional order. Allah has put the order, if you fear that you cannot do justice among the women, or then you marry two and three, four. And if you fear that you cannot do you cannot be equitable, then you marry only one. So it is a conditional order on men, believing men, that if suppose the man cannot remove the fear, then he cannot marry.
If the man removes the fear, then but then he has to be still fair to all the wives.
No.
Just by removing the fear does not allow him to marry again. That means he has to even practice, he has to be equal to all the wives.
No, he cannot be equal. That's why I discussed.
No, but if by removing the fear is very easy, no? Anyone can say, okay, I'll remove the fear.
No, he cannot.
He's still equal to, equal to all his wives.
No, no, he can never be equal. You see, you must understand, no man, Allah said that وَلَن تَسْتَذِيُوا أَلَّا تَعْدِلُوا بَيْنَ النِّسَىٰ. Allah said the men do not have the capability to be equitable to between women. They can never ever be equitable. They cannot, they don't have the capacity. That means Allah is giving them excuse that you can marry more than wife because you cannot, I will not catch you, why didn't you be equitable? So they don't have the capacity or capability to be equal between two wives at all. In emotionally they cannot be equitable, even in attraction, even in spending also. Even in their liking, woman is different. Some women like different, the other woman like different. Every woman is a different. So they can never ever be equitable. But some men wishfully think that they have to be equitable. Allah says you can never be. And women also putting that you have to be fair, equal. They have to be fair, justified, they have to be. They can do justice, but they can never be equal.
Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to Muhammad Sheikh's channel. Please click the bell icon so that you may receive timely notifications of our upcoming videos.